A very important turning point in my life was a time when I broke out of my older sister's shadow. My parents used to tell me that when I was little, around like 3 or 4 years old, that I would always follow Jessica around. Jessica's my older sister. At like little parties and gatherings with the family, they told me that Jessica was always the center of attention. She would always be the one talking to different people, you know, dancing, and I would always be right there, but I'd be like right up behind her, staying quiet, looking down, and holding her hands. Like, I was not the social one. I was super shy, and I did whatever she did. We went to Catholic school together. We also did a lot of sports there. We were in basketball, volleyball, softball. We were also in the drill team, and we also did Girl Scouts. So we basically, like, whatever she wanted to do, I just followed. But like through that time period, like, people would just refer to, like, oh, Jessica and her sister. And at first that never really bothered me, because, like, I never really thought about it. I'm like 7, 8 years old, you know, just, it didn't really bother me. But they'd always refer to her first. It didn't start bothering me until I got into high school, where I started hearing that name constantly. I would pass people through the halls, and like teachers or her friends would come up to me and be like, they'd look at me like they're like, I would look strange, and I was just looking at them because, you know, I'm a freshman and I didn't know anyone. I'm like, oh, you're Jessica's sister, right? And I said, oh, yeah, I am. And like, I just had to get used to it, and always would be like, oh, you're Jessica's little sister. They didn't know my name. Little Jessica. And I'm just like, that's my name. But okay. So, and it even kind of showed through my family. I mean, they didn't call me Jessica's little sister, but they'd always be like, oh, Jessica, what are you and your sister doing? And I'm just like, oh, well, we're doing this. I joined cheer my freshman year, and that was because of her. So it was just different things like that. Unfortunately, this didn't change until my junior year. That's when she was already gone. I decided to become really involved in school. I was, like I said, I was a cheerleader. I was a cheerleader for all 4 years. I was in the business academy at my school. I was also in student council. And my senior year, I was the ASB president. So soon, teachers and faculty started calling me by my first name, because I was there the whole summer. So I was always talking to people, always like planning things. So people started to like call me by my first name. I'm like, okay, cool. Like, finally know my name. And even like through my family, I could see them like, oh, what's new in your life? Like, what are you doing? Well, you're part of school. That's great. I can see you're working really hard, blah, blah, blah. So it's all like that kind of stuff. I was really excited the fact that, like, I broke out of my sister's shadow. You know, I didn't like to be called Jessica's little sister, because, you know, I'm my own person. I am related to her, but that's not my name. The good thing about what really surprised me was breaking out of my sister's shadow and people knowing me for who I was, especially being the ASB president my senior year, was that I had a lot of the underclassmen looking up to me, so I had to be, you know, the good, responsible, always behaving, always going to class on time, you know. So basically the good girl, and that put a lot of, like, stress, because, like, I didn't want to mess up. I hated, like my biggest fear were teachers coming up to me and being like, why are you doing this? You're supposed to set an example. Like, I don't like getting reprimanded at all. So, but, you know, in the end, I think it was really worth it to have people know me as Marissa and not Jessica's sister.